Hello friends, welcome to the video series on Oracle Collections. In this video, we'll learn about associative array. We will start our learning in comparison with vArray and nested table. So here is an example for vArray to store a maximum of 7 varchar data. After initialization, I'm storing the name of the day in each index location. Same way, we can retrieve the data stored by specifying the index ID. Similarly, here is an example for nested table, where I am storing the same information. The only difference between vArray and nested table is, in vArray, the upper bound is fixed. That is, the maximum number of elements that can be stored in the vArray is defined at the definition time itself. However, in nested table, there is no maximum upper bound. We can extend and store as per the need during runtime. In both vArray and nested table, the index is predefined and maintained by Oracle. That is, whenever we initialize or use the extend function, Oracle automatically allocate the next memory location and we can access the last memory location to store the data. In fact, we can use the last function to know the index of the last allocated memory location. In associative array, the index part along with the value part is user defined. That is, as a user or developer, we can decide what to store in the index portion and what to store in the value portion. This is the major functional difference between associative array compared to nested table and vArray. Let me reiterate the key concept here. In associative array, the index is not sequential number. Instead, it's a user-defined value. Hence, using the index and the value portion, we can able to store the associated or related key value pair informations. Maybe that's the reason this is called associative array. Here is an example for associative array where I am defining the index portion as varchar data type. Hence, against day 1 index ID, I am storing Monday and subsequently all the other days of the week. This is just for the introduction only. In the subsequent slides, we will understand in detail about associative array. As I mentioned, associative array is a set of key value pair information. This is similar to hash table in any other programming languages. This is otherwise called as PL SQL table or nested index by table. The index can be either of varchar type or PLS integer data type. Now let us see how to use associative array. Similar to varchar, vArray and nested table, we need to follow the similar steps like define, declare, assign and access to access the data from the associative array. First step is to define the associative array. Here we are defining our custom type to mention both the type of the index and the value portion. Here is the syntax to define the associative array. The additional index by data type keyword specifies what should be the data type of index portion. The next step is to declare a variable of the defined associative type. This is similar to vArray and nested table. The next step is to assign the value. Here is the key difference between associative array to vArray and nested table. For vArray and nested table, we had an additional step of initialization either as part of the variable declaration or using the extend function. This step is not needed for associative array. Whenever you need, you can specify the unique key value and can assign the data. After assignment, the next step is to access the value from the associative array. So this is very similar to vArray and nested table. By specifying the index key, we can access the value specified in the particular location. Now let us see how to use the function as part of the associative array variables. So here is the list of function what we saw for vArray and nested table, but there is slight difference here. Few of the functions are not applicable for associative array. For example, limit, trim and extend function. These three functions are not applicable for associative array. The rest of the functions like count, first, last, delete, prior, next, and exist, all these things are applicable. Associative array will not preserve the order in which it is assigned. Instead, it sorts as per the key value. That's why the first function returns black and the last function returns white. This is another difference between associative array compared to vArray nested table. Now let us see the hands-on. So here is the first program where we are assigning the color code into the associative array. Then we are just accessing and printing the information. Now let us see the hands-on for the functions. Let us see the first function, that is the count. So in this associative array, we actually assign 5 values. Let us see the next function. The first function will return the index of the first value. In this case, it is black. Since it is in sorted order, we are getting the black as the first index. Now let us see what is the last index. Obviously, the last index is white as per the sorted order. So we should get the index ID as white. Yes, we got the index of the last index as per the last function is white. Now let us see the next function, delete. So delete function will delete all the elements of the vArray. So let us first print the count so that after delete, we'll be able to see the count as 0. So before deletion, there are 5 elements in this associative array. Now let me just use the delete function, delete method. Now if you see, after deletion, we are getting the count as 0. So similarly, we can use the delete of the particular index. So specify the index. So after deleting blue, now we are getting count as 4. We can even give an index that is not exist. Associative array will not give any error here. Now let us see the next function called prior and next. Prior will give the index of the previous array, previous value, and the next will give the index of the next information for whatever you are giving. For example, suppose if you want to know what is the prior of blue, ideally we will get black. So let us say the associative array dot prior of blue, so that we will get black. Same way, prior next of blue, we should get the green. First we will see what is the value of prior of blue. Let me just execute this program. So prior of blue, we are now getting black. Same way, now we can see what is the next index of blue. Now if you see next index of blue, we are getting green. Okay, the next function is exist function. Exist function will check and tell whether a particular index exists or not. For example, in this particular set of color code, let us check whether a yellow exists or not. So we can say if associative array dot exists of yellow, this typically returns a boolean value. So if it is true, we can print a meaningful information, something like this color code exists. For example, in this case, I'm just trying to print yellow exists. If it is false, let us print a meaningful value information like yellow not exists. Let me execute it here. Now, if you can see here, yellow exists. If you have learned something new, please like this video, subscribe, and stay tuned for new feature videos, interview questions, SQL practical questions, and concept videos. Thanks a lot for watching this video.